What is it about Tesla automobiles that ensures their continued market dominance? The architecture or the underlying technology? If your response was the latter, then you have the proper answer. And given Tesla's amazing new engine was only just unveiled by Elon Musk, we are going to go into the reasons why Tesla's electric vehicles are leading the industry with it. Hello everyone, welcome back to the Future Space. In today's video, we bring you the most recent news about the new engine of Tesla, and that will freak you out. But before we begin, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon so you don't miss any of our amazing videos. Now let's begin. The origins and development of electric propulsion electric vehicles first came into existence in the middle of the 19th century, at a time when electricity was one of the most popular means for the propulsion of motor vehicles. Electricity offered a level of convenience and ease of use that gasoline-powered automobiles were unable to compete with. The advent of technological improvements in the construction of electric locomotives led to the widespread adoption of electric rail travel by the 20th century. Their general-purpose commercial employment was eventually superseded by other vehicles such as platform trucks, forklift trucks, ambulances, tow tractors, and urban delivery vehicles such as the iconic milk float used in the UK. The UK was the country that used the most electric cars on the road over the majority of the 20th century. The use of electric vehicles has seen a decline in popularity as a consequence of a variety of different issues. The development of better road infrastructure necessitated a longer range than electric cars could provide. Additionally, the discovery of large petroleum reserves in Texas, Oklahoma, and California led to the widespread availability of low-cost gasoline and petrol, which made it more cost-effective for internal combustion engines to operate over long distances. In 1912, Charles Kettering invented the electric starter, which eliminated the need for a hand crank to start a gasoline engine. Additionally, in 1897, Hiram Percy Maxim invented the muffler, which made the noise that was emitted by internal combustion engine cars more bearable. These two inventions made it possible for ICE cars to become easier to operate, and they also made it possible for ICE cars to emit less noise. When highways outside of cities were developed, the electric car range was no longer able to compete with that of internal combustion engines. In 1913, Henry Ford pioneered the mass production of gasoline-powered vehicles, which resulted in a significant reduction in the price of gasoline automobiles when compared to the price of electric vehicles. How the drivetrain of an EV operates? When was the last time you gave some attention to how electric vehicles perform their functions? It is connected to magnetism and the natural interaction between electric and magnetic fields in the universe. Electrons produce a magnetic field that has a north pole and a south pole when an electrical circuit is closed, which enables electrons to move down a wire. When this occurs in the presence of another magnetic field, the poles that are opposed to each other attract each other, while the poles that are similar to each other repel each other. The operation of electric motors is accomplished by fastening one set of magnets or electromagnets to a shaft and another set of magnets or electromagnets to the housing that encompasses the shaft. By switching the polarity of one pair of electromagnets at regular intervals, the motor is able to rotate the shaft, so transforming electricity into torque and ultimately turning the wheels. This is accomplished by using the forces of attraction and repulsion. In the process of regenerative braking, the same magnetic and electromagnet forces may also be responsible for converting motion into electricity. The electricity that is supplied to your house is known as alternating current, or AC for short. This type of current gets its name from the fact that the polarity of the power shifts 60 times in 1 second. In other words, alternating current of 110 volts is utilized in the US and other nations, whereas AC of 50 Hz is often used in nations whose voltage norm is 220 volts. The positive and negative poles of each battery are the entry and exit points for direct current, often known as DC. To turn, motors need to be supplied with alternating current, as was mentioned earlier. If the electromagnetic force did not exist, their north and south poles would have no choice but to become entangled with one another. The cycle of continuously switching north and south will keep a motor turning as long as it is given the opportunity. The transmission of useful energy across great distances from its point of generation using AC power is the most effective method currently available, such as a dam or windmill. This is possible because of the alternating nature of the AC signal, which makes it possible for the voltage to be easily adjusted to a variety of various levels. Because of this, the voltage of the outlets in your house is a safe 120 volts AC, whereas the voltage of a distribution transformer, those cylindrical gray boxes you see on power line poles, can be as high as 66 kVA, 66,000 volts AC. Because AC power enables us to construct substantially more efficient generators, motors, and distribution systems from electricity, it is the energy current that is most chosen for use in powering cars. Direct current is an example of such technology development. Gasoline-powered vehicles are beginning to fall behind their electric equivalents and may eventually surpass them. Even though there is still a long way to go for electric automobiles, the advancements that companies like Tesla and Toyota have achieved to this point have given optimism that transportation will no longer be dependent on fossil fuels in the future, even though there is still a long way to go for electric automobiles. We are all aware of the achievements that Tesla has made in this industry at this point, such as the fact that the Tesla Model S sedan is able to travel up to 288 miles, reach 155 miles per hour, and produce 687 pound-feet of torque. Tesla's uniqueness, according to the estimates provided by the EPA, the most recent version of Tesla's Model S, the Long Range Plus, has a range of 402 miles. Since the vehicle's version with 100 kilowatt hours was introduced in 2016, this represents an increase of 87 miles in its maximum range. Instead of depending on a Tier 1 vendor for its motor, inverter, battery pack, and other components, Tesla manufactures its own components in-house. This helps Tesla achieve its goal. Because it uses a do-it-yourself approach, Tesla is able to continuously modify those components in order to improve their efficiency. The battery serves as the primary power source for the system. Tesla, in contrast to other automakers, such as Audi, Toyota, and Mercedes, enables users to use the full capacity of their vehicle's battery pack. This means that the owner of the Model S has access to the full 100 kilowatt hours of battery capacity, rather than having some capacity held in reserve to ensure that the battery lasts as long as possible. An engineer with Tesla claims that the company has never left any part of the battery out of any of its products, including automobiles. Batteries have a finite lifespan, and other manufacturers of automobiles have come to an agreement that in the event that some of the cells die, there will be backups ready to take their place. As an illustration, the battery pack of an Audi e-tron has a capacity of 95.3. However, that is an overall statistic. The pack has a capacity of 86.5 when it is really being used. There are also some subtle variations in pack capacity, according to Tesla. According to the company, the energy storage capability of a Model S battery ranges between 100 and 105 kWh. When you drive the Model S Long Range Plus, the car will let you know if you have used 96.2 kWh and have reached a point where there are no more useful miles. Even though the 102.5 kWh pack itself still had around 6.3 of energy left over, Tesla claims that the system was developed to operate in a manner analogous to that of a gas tank that has a reserve. The fact that drivers are given the full package from the very beginning has a number of benefits, but one of the drawbacks is that battery degradation is more obvious. When cell function is no longer being produced, there is no buffer. The battery packs covered by Tesla's warranty are guaranteed to keep at least 70% of their original capacity for the duration of the 8-year, 100 to 150,000 mile coverage period. By cutting down on the amount of waste produced by the engine, the range may be enhanced. If an electric vehicle's motor is more efficient, the range that it can achieve while driving is also increased. Car and Driver was informed by Tesla that the efficiency of the Model S's motor has increased from 80 to 90%. With a peak efficiency of 94% achieved during EPA testing cycles. And that's it for today, guys. We sincerely hope you enjoyed this video. If so, please click on the like button and share it with your friends and family. If you have any questions or comments, please share them with us in the comment space below. I see you find the video interesting, so don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon for future updates. You can also check out our other videos that have been specially selected for you. We'll catch up in the next video.